Steve has invited me to do the Selkirk Race by Robert Burns, and we will follow that with a toast to the haggis. So, ladies and gentlemen, can I ask you please to have silence for the Selkirk Race? Some can eat and gotta eat, and some will eat the lot it. But we can eat and we can eat and see the Lord, we thank it. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please charge your glasses? The toast is the haggis. Thank you.
Thank you, Greg. Toast in the haggis in Cannock. We've toasted haggis many times here in Cannock. We're top table heaving with great fighters. Jim Watt, Ken Buchanan, I think Dick McTaggart's been here, arguably the greatest ever amateur boxer. My name's Steve Barnes, welcome to Barstool and England against Scotland. Thank you very much. England against Scotland, they're in the 50s and the 60s. England against Scotland was filmed by the BBC and it was shown the next night. And those in the room old enough to remember that, and there are one or two people certainly on the left-hand side here, will remember those nights when those glorious fights involving boxers like Dick McTaggart and boxers like Frankie Taylor, they were shown on the BBC, but they weren't shown live. And it was amazing how often Harry Carpenter was absolutely perfect with his prediction. He'd tell you to watch out for this particular kid, watch out for Jim McCabe's left hook. It's a fantastic left hook, and of course, 3 seconds later, the left hook would land and down would go the opponent. That's the benefit of watching a fight the day after and putting commentary on. But those were phenomenal events. England and Scotland was always the biggest of the international amateur boxing fixtures. And in some ways, it still is. There's nothing up for grabs. There's no specific cup or glory medal. But the rivalry between the English and the Scottish boxers on the squad system, that means when they arrive in Sheffield, where for 10 years we've had a centre of excellence, which has turned us into one of the top three amateur boxing countries in the world. When the boxers get there, the Welsh, they do their bit, it's not a problem, and the English, even the guys from the South Coast, they get on with everybody else, and the Scots get on with the people, don't get me wrong. But that's the fiercest set of rivalry, the fiercest sets of sparring are when the Scottish amateur boxers are competing against their English counterparts at the British squad system. And it just so happens that some of the big rivalries have been at the same weight. So an English boxer at 60 kilos lightweight, and the man standing between him and the Olympics is a Scottish boxer at 60 kilos. Some of those training sessions, you pay the kind of money for that you couldn't actually afford. You really just couldn't. It's that good. So tonight, we've got a lineup of different boxers stepping forward. Now, I always tell people at the amateur shows here that Scott Murray puts on here about a dozen each year. I always tell people to have a look very closely at the menu. Flip the menu over and you'll see on the back the names of the boxers. Bout number one, a kid called Frank Middleton against a kid called Patrick Patton. They're schoolboys, that means they'll be about 15 years of age and they weigh about 7 stone. Now, it's worth taking a look at these programs. It's worth keeping it. It's worth folding it away and putting it in your pocket, because there's a man over here called Frank Sullivan. Now, Frank Sullivan's been working in boxing for about 60 years. He's produced world champions. He's produced Olympians, European amateur champions, world amateur champions, one of the finest and most underrated and humble men you could possibly meet in boxing. And he'll tell you that when you look at this list of boxers here tonight, there's just a chance that one of those men there might be a man in 10 years' time that's topping the bill in Saudi Arabia Saturday week. Because I remember about 10 years ago being at a working men's club in East London, and there was a young kid on the bill having his third contest. And it said in the program, A.Joshua. And it was Anthony Joshua fighting Dillian White. Dillian White's first contest, Joshua's second contest. I remember being at a working man's club in Rotherham in 1984, covering something with a man called Brendan Ingall, and he had a young kid fighting who was 12 years of age, cocky, flash, a really funny kid, a lovely kid. And in the program, his name was N. Hammond, and I've still got those programs, I've still got those sheets. So when you look at this sheet of paper, you look at all of the names on it, just have a little thing that, you know, one of those one day might actually be something. In fact, there's a kid boxing tonight, it's in the last contest. He's a kid called Delicious, which is not a bad name to start with, to be perfectly honest with you. If your name's Delicious, you're not really desperately hungry to find a nickname. That's a nickname in itself. So who knows, if the stuff I'm hearing about Delicious, if half of it's true, this kid Delicious will be sending me and some of the people I work with to New York or Las Vegas or Saudi Arabia, I don't know, maybe even just to Manchester or Newcastle to cover a fight. So keep your eyes open for this kid Delicious. But before the able-bodied boxing takes place tonight, there is something unique happening in Canada tonight. There is something that will be happening for the very first time anywhere in the world this evening. We're going to have a mixed contest in this ring. In fact, we're not going to call it a contest, we're going to call it a showcase bout. In one corner, in a specially adapted sporting wheelchair, there will be a boxer, yes, in a wheelchair. And in the other corner, there will be another boxer in a wheelchair. But each have head guards on, but you'll be able to tell. One of them is a man, and one of them is a woman. This has never happened before in a showcase bout situation. In fact, the two people involved, Louise Faye and Chris, and this is true, he insists on being called this, Chris Legless Middleton, they did this before for just 60 seconds last month, or earlier this month, in Mexico at the World Boxing Council Congress Convention down there in Cancun, in front of 90 world champions, including, if I'm not mistaken, Mike Tyson, Marvin Hagler, Sugar Ray Leonard, I mean the greatest world champions in history. And for 60 seconds, 1 minute, all of those boxing legends, all of that boxing royalty, shut up and watched as these two fought or boxed or whatever you want to call it. I'm not even sure what to call it. We'll find out in about an hour's time. They put on a 60-second exhibition, and there were 1,500 people at the convention in addition to the 90 boxers, and they got nearly a 5-minute standing ovation. So tonight, at some point in the next 60 or 7 minutes, every single person in this room is going to see a bit of history, as we have here in Canada the first ever showcase bout between both a man and a woman, wheelchair boxing, delivered by an organisation called the WBC. And they've got a programme here, and it's run by a man called Scott Welch, who once fought for a world title in sub-zero temperatures in Tennessee. It was a national emergency. I like details. I'm a big believer in details, Scott, you understand me? Because I can just say you fought for the world title and you lost it, and you won, that doesn't capture it. It was a national emergency in Tennessee. The president actually held like a news conference to apologize, as though he was in touch with God or someone. It was the coldest anyone had ever been. And in this arena, Scott went 12 rounds fighting for the world heavyweight title. And I tell you what, the man who beat him, Henry Akinwunmi, I think in his next fight, he lost to Lennox Lewis, but he dropped Lennox Lewis. He didn't drop Scott. But that's a true story. Coldest non-heavyweight title fight I've ever been at. Anyway, Scott's delivered this wheelchair contest as part of the WBC Cares UK program. So please, when they start assembling the wheelchairs in the ring, and you're watching, and I think you'll be inspired. And before that, I won't say too much, but you might, if you're lucky, get 10 minutes with one of, well, I'm not even quite sure how to title this man. I'm not quite sure how to go through not just his injuries, but it's this sort of recovery point. So I won't bother, because I know when I'm beaten, I don't mind being around people when I've got no chance of competing with them. When you're on this top table here with Squires and Gig, and Marvin Hackler's in full flow, you just sit down and shut up, because you can't compete with Marvelous One. But tonight we're going to hear from a man who is more than just a survivor, that doesn't quite capture it. That's going to be before the wheelchair contest. So as we're calling it, so we don't want to upset people, the showcase bout. So I'm going to sit back and enjoy what's going to be the latest addition in one of the oldest running rivalries in amateur boxing. England against Scotland here at Barstool. Thanks very much. Enjoy every single contest tonight.